Welcome back to Facing Waves. This week, Nikki Gregg is exploring the beautiful and historical country of Jordan.
Qais is a small village. We first visited a local Bedouin home where we had the traditional meal called mansaf, and it's rice, meat, and you put a little bit of this yogurt, which makes it taste delicious. After our lunch with the local family in Qais, we went to the local historical site where there are ruins.
Qais is again a Greco-Roman site, and it shares the same exact history of the rest of the region. But the most important is actually the location. The site was built with the black stones, like the black volcanic stones.
Our guide took us around and showed us the whole area, which incredible scenery, by the way. But what was interesting is he used to live there.
My name is Ahmed Al-Umari. I'm from Qais, from Gadara. I'm working as a local guide, and also I'm from the local community. I was born in this site, and I'm standing right now in the front of our old house where I was born. We used to live as a natural life. We eat what we have in our fields. Also, every monument here got a local name. We call the theater like Mal'abe. This is for example.
And I really liked getting to know our guide. Such a nice person. We went up onto the rooftop where he showed me the beautiful valley and showed us the Sea of Galilee, which is where it is said that Jesus walked on water. In the center of Amman is the citadel. You walk in and there's these huge structures.
Well, Amman is the capital city of Jordan. We're talking about 4 million people that lives in the city. If you head to the old part in the city, there's these archaeological sites popping out like in the middle of the city.
And to be able to stand and be around these huge pillars and literally touch history.
The citadel was one of the main stations of people settlements in Jordan, where people first decided to live in one of the mountains until the Greek came in, until the Roman came in, until the Muslims came in. So you can see layers of history that was built on top of each other while looking at the new buildings of the city.
Amman is a huge city, but the downtown area called a souk is a very cool marketplace. It's very important for people to interact, to talk. You don't just roll into someone's house, say hi, grab your things and go. The Jordanian people really want to get to know who we are, where we're from, why we're here. And I'm not used to that. I actually haven't missed home once since I've been here. When we headed south from Amman to the Dana Natural Reserve, I was expecting to head into the desert right away. However, it's a huge canyon, mountainous, it's green, it's absolutely beautiful, not what I expected at all.
Basically, Dana Natural Reserve is one of the most unique sites in Jordan, actually laying down literally on the edge of the Rift Valley, the greatest rift in the world, make a huge geological variety of the nature. So by walking 6 hours hike from the very top to down at the bottom, you'll get to see a different lifestyle, the animal life, the vegetation.
And what I really like is getting away from the city. So getting into the country where it's just wide open, beautiful, you know, more solitude there. The campsite in the Dana Natural Reserve is just totally out there, quiet, and lots of nature. You know, life is brimming, and our tents were set up just over the canyon. And when I woke up in the morning early, the sun was coming up. It's nice and cool in the desert in the morning, so you get up, have your coffee. If you need to get away from life and relax, this is the place to come. The Finan Eco Lodge is really unique.
Finan was built on the lower end of Dana Natural Reserve. That place is literally in the middle of nowhere.
You arrive at the reception area, transfer your luggage, and you're transported about 20 minutes to the Eco Lodge.
I am Ali Hassassin, working Eco Guide in the Finan Eco Lodge. The lodge located in the southwest of Dana Biosphere Reserve. It's the only reserve in Jordan which include the four different climate zones. The lodge, it's a green building, friendly for the nature, so it's all the lodge are lit by the candles, electricity are by solar panels, we recycle the waste. Also at the lodge we use the clay jars, we don't use the plastic bottles for water. Every year we reduce 10 to 15,000 plastic bottles in the nature.
The Bedouin experience is unique because you're fully immersed in the culture, literally.
The coffee, it's not only something to drink it, it has a lot of meanings in our life and in our culture. You can learn how to make it and how much you can drink. What's the meaning if you drink more than the normal, if you refuse?
It's a huge tradition with them. You have a certain amount of cups of coffee and it means it's significant in a certain way. And how many cups? If you have too many cups, it's disrespectful to the host. And going through this, it's like, it's very important to them. And I'll never look at coffee the same way again after coming to Jordan. We went for a sunset hike from the Eco Lodge with our guide, Ali. And I got to learn a lot about his lifestyle, his family. It was not only amazing because of the scenery, the mountains in the background, the beautiful sunset, but I got to know someone new and learn about their life. To actually go and sit down and learn about this culture firsthand is what you need to do if you come to Jordan. So I'm speaking to you from one of the seven wonders of the world. So I'm the top of Petra, and it's an incredible experience. Of course, I've heard a lot about Petra, but it wasn't until I walked in and saw it with my own eyes that it was just this very emotional experience. First thing you see after walking through the Sikh, which is the narrow valley when the walls come together and it's very narrow, and all of a sudden it opens up and there's the treasury. You see it for the first time and it's actually somewhat emotional, like I almost teared up. And you walk in and it's a large area and it's just absolutely beautiful. And a lot of people, of course, know this spot from the movie Indiana Jones, but there's so much more to it. There's so much history.
Petra is a huge archaeological site. A lot of people misunderstand that there are 820 different monuments beside Petra, or what we call the Indiana Jones building. The site is so big that you need 3 days to fully explore it. It's one of the seven wonders. It's a World Heritage Site. Petra is unique because there are no other examples in the world. The city was carved into the sandstone mountains. So the people who established the Nabataean civilization are the Thamudic tribes that used to live in the Arabian Peninsula. And they built a huge station and they established the new state, the Nabataean states. It was the holy place inside the capital of the Nabataean states.
We opted to take some donkeys up to the top because it is a steep hike. So we rented some donkeys from a local and hiked up the stairs, and it was really fun. And along the way, there's some shops, and we talked with some of the locals. You have to walk up almost 1,000 steps to see the monastery. And we came to the very top, which is an amazingly beautiful viewpoint of the valley. I can't really put into words how I feel right now, where I'm sitting and the history here, and that I have the opportunity to come here and experience this. The Red Sea is very interesting because it's bordered by several different countries.
The Red Sea at the Gulf of Aqaba, the city Aqaba, it's a small beach town in Jordan at the very south borders of Jordan, where you can literally see four different countries. You can see Israel to the western side, Egypt just further down south from Israel, further south from Jordan, Saudi Arabia. It's just a wonderful place where you can see four different countries surrounding the place.
But to actually be here and be one of the first people to stand up paddle on it is pretty amazing. There's so much history. I don't know a lot about the Bible, but I do know that this is the historic place where it is said that Moses parted the Red Sea. And where we're at in Jordan, you know, I look across here right now and I can see Israel. So the fact that there's so many different countries and cultures surrounding this inlet of the Indian Ocean is pretty cool.
It's one of the most wonderful places in the world to do snorkeling, diving. The hotels was built in the shores of the Dead Sea. It's very beautiful hotel serving a lot of different activities at the sea, the lifestyle, the restaurants, the food. It's not a place for only tourists. A lot of local Jordanians just go down to Aqaba to hang out with their families.